Thanks.
You know, Mom knew I wouldn't have any problems tonight.
She was right.
Yeah, but how does she know? You know, just once I wish she would say, a platinum album, kids. That's amazing. Or how many people were in that audience? That's a lot of people. But instead, it's like she expects it, you know? Does that drive you crazy?
Mom's mom. She believes in us. I thought you were going to share this with me.
Well, I'm too keyed up.
So have a quaalude. It'll relax you.
You take too many of those things.
Now you sound like Mom. You know, you didn't have to babysit me. You should have gone out.
No. I love Lucy, but she's always trying to fix me up, you know? You know that all the guys care about is, like, say they've been with a rock star or something stupid like that. I'm never gonna find somebody who just wants me.
Yeah, you will. Someday.
Hmm. We're never in one place long enough. I can just see it now. I'll have a cottage in Connecticut and the station wagon and the kids. And my husband will wear those plaid flannel shirts, you know, the red ones with the black lines on them.
How many are you gonna have?
Shirts?
No, kids.
Oh. I don't know, at least two. If my husband's really cute, I don't know, how would you feel, Richard, about being the uncle to about 12 kids? Rich?
When did you pick up this beauty?
This morning. Do you like it?
You know I love these 59 Furies.
Well, Dad, this 59 Fury has got your name on it.
Oh, no. No, no, kids, no. Come on, no. You just bought us the house. Come on, no.
We love you.
Oh,
what else are we supposed to do with our money, huh?
Oh. Save it.
No, it's boring.
Oh, for...
Wait.
Agnes, look at this.
Mom. We didn't forget about you.
Heavens.
Would you look at that?
What on earth?
We found it in this incredible store in Tokyo.
Oh, my.
It must have cost a fortune.
It's beautiful, Mom. Try it on.
You're worth it, Mom.
Let me help.
What?
Does it have sleeves?
Yeah, it
is. It's like a
sleeves.
Maze getting in that thing, isn't it?
Feels like silk.
It is silk, Dad.
There you go.
Karen, it's so sweet of you.
Oh.
But where am I ever going to wear something like this?
Well, anywhere. Wear it around the house if you want.
Oh, Karen.
Oh, it's beautiful on you, Mom.
Oh, I think you should have asked me.
I'm sorry. I
but it's
you'd...
lovely. Really. Well, now, come on. I've just been dying to show you around the house.
Oh, yes.
You're going to be surprised when you see how much we've done since you left. You won't believe it.
Really?
I thought this room at the top of the stairs on the right would be best for you, Karen. And the one across the hall would be yours, Richard.
What's the matter, kiddo?
Karen, don't you want to see your room?
Oh, Mom, you don't expect us to live with you forever, do you?
Well, no, not forever. When you get married, you'll have your own home.
Mom, we're not little kids anymore.
You know, one time I told that Lucy friend of yours that when you and Richard made a lot of money, you wouldn't lose your basic values. I hope I wasn't wrong.
Mom, stop it. I'm 24 years old. Don't make me feel guilty for wanting to move away from home.
Karen, I think if you took a look at the room your mother fixed up for you, you'll find there aren't any bars on the window.
Daddy, that's not the
point. Besides, it's not like you'll be in town all that much.
Mom. What Karen means is that we've been thinking about sharing a house of our own. Here in Downey, maybe.
Here in Downey?
Yeah.
Why didn't you say so? Harold, I don't think we'd have any objection to that, do you?
No, not at all.
Well, come on up and look anyway.
Okay.
You know our neighbors, the Batemans?
Yeah, down the street?
Uh-huh. Their nephew is a real estate agent, and I know he could be a big help.
Well, she got a nice car, and she cruised through the hamburger stand now.
Can you? Wonderful.
She forgot all about the library, but she told her all that now.
No, I...
And with the radio playing, she goes
kidding.
Hey, Sherwin, we were starting to wonder what happened to you.
Well, you lived in Brentwood where you belong. Maybe I could find this place. Rich, Lynn.
It's nice to meet you.
Come on in.
Sherwin, you never told me your daughter was this pretty.
Well, why do you keep her stashed in an Eastern column?
Oh, yeah, no kidding. I'm originally from Connecticut.
I know.
She's a big fan of you.
Daddy, this is for your house.
Thank you.
Sherwin, you made it.
Yeah, you found it.
Ready?
Hey, so, Carpenter, where's the vino? If I have to drink iced tea...
There is some of that great 1970 Chardonnay in the refrigerator. It's right around the corner. Clock. That is perfect.
You like it?
Yes, it's great. Thank you so much.
If you tell me that he's got a great personality, it's a pass. He's got a great personality. He's a bon vivant. Bon vivant. Well, he's going to tell me bon voyage when he finds out that I like to bowl. Karen, just give him a chance. He's fantastic. Look, he's in New York now. I want him to call you as soon as he gets back. His name's Peter Howard, and Sherwin's thinking of hiring him. Lucy, thanks, but no thanks. No one in the business. Just buys you trouble. I don't think Richard would mind. Getting back to the point, he's not married, he's not gay, and he doesn't want your money. He's not a gold digger. He's got his own. So? What excuses can you come up with now? Okay, I'll go. But I don't have to like
it. Every day.
Good night. Had a really nice time. Thanks, Peter.
Karen, this isn't our first day, and it might have come to your attention that I'm in love with you. So, Miss Carpenter, I was wondering, but you ever going to invite me in for milk and cookies?
You've grown so deep inside of me. You're
oops. Forget your bowling ball.
And you're the one I love. All my life,
Rich, you're out of iced tea. Do you want something else?
No, it's okay. I'm kind of sleepy. I think I'm just gonna crash. Why don't you come on up?
Oh, you're home early.
Hey, Pete, Casey, how was the bowling?
It was fine, Rich.
Good night. See you in the morning.
Would you mind if I...
No, that's okay.
I'm really sorry.
I'll call you tomorrow.
I want her out of here.
My house, too, remember?
You're practically living together. It's not fair to me.
What are you so upset about?
Last night?
What happened last night?
Damn well what happened last night.
What?
Oh, my God, Richard.
I don't care what Mom says. You have to get off those quaaludes.
Now, just hold on a minute. Before you start lecturing me, you want to talk about you?
What about me?
Well, all you eat is salads. You skip meals. You don't take care of yourself. And what about those little boxes of laxatives up in your medicine cabinet?
I don't know about those. Was she sleeping through my cabinets?
No, I found them.
And I bet you told her, too. That is exactly...